गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन. सो इन द लास्ट सेशन वी हैव स्टार्टेड विद दिस चैप्टर एंड वी हैव रेड अबाउट इंडिया, द एरिया ऑफ द इंडिया. इट इज़ द वेरी सेकेंड, इट इज़ द सेकेंड लार्जेस्ट कंट्री इन द टर्म्स ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन एंड सेवेंथ लार्जेस्ट कंट्री इन द वर्ल्ड. ऑल्सो इट इज़ लोकेटेड इन द साउथर्न एशिया. साउथर्न एशिया मीन्स साउथर्न पार्ट ऑफ द एशिया. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट वी हैव रेड दिस ऑल्सो. हेयर इट इज़ रिटन दैट इंडिया इज डिवाइडेड इंटू 28 स्टेट्स एंड 9 यूनियन टेरिटरीज. बट इट वॉज देयर वर 9 यूनियन टेरिटरीज बट नाउ देयर आर ओनली 8 यूनियन टेरिटरीज एज पर द न्यू रूल्स दैट दमन एंड दीव एंड दादर एंड नागर हवेली दे आर दी टू यूनियन टेरिटरीज विच अर्लियर यूज टू बी द सेपरेट वन. लाइक यू कैन सी दैट देर आर 8 यूनियन टेरिटरीज. अंडमान एंड निकोबार आइलैंड्स, चंडीगढ़, दादर एंड नागर हवेली, दमन एंड दीव, लक्षद्वीप, पुडुचेरी, जम्मू एंड कश्मीर, National Capital Territory of Delhi and then Ladakh. These are the 8 Union Territories. Earlier, what is there? Why they were 9? Because Dadar and Nagar Haveli was the one and Daman and Diu was the another one. So that is why these were counted as the 2 separate Union Territories. But from 26 January 2020, it is now considered as a one. They have been combined now and now these two union territories are considered as a one territory only. So that is why it has come to 8 instead of 9. Okay. So everyone has to remember that this is 8 now, 8 union territories after the 26th January. 26 January 2020. From this date, after this date, there are 8 union territories. But before 26 January 2020, there used to be 9 union territories. Okay. So we have talked till here that there are 28 states in India and 8 union territories, and also the extent from north to south and west to east. That is from north to south, it is Kashmir to Kanyakumari. From Kashmir to Kanyakumari is the north to south extent. Whereas from Gujarat to Arunachal Pradesh is a from west to east extent. Extent means from here to here, this is from Gujarat to Arunachal Pradesh. It stretches from here to here. Starts from here, it stretches from here to here. And same way from Jammu to Kanyakumari. Now moving forward, the southern part, we have talked about this also, that the southern part of the India is surrounded by the three water bodies. And you know what, when anything which is surrounded by the waters on the three sides. If something is surrounded by the water on the three sides, 1, 2, and 3, it means it is also known as the peninsula. Peninsula. What it is known as? Peninsula. So this much we have done in the last session. Now we'll start from here. Asia is the largest continent. Asia is the largest continent in the world and comprises about 30% of the Earth's total area. India is located in the southern part of the Asia. What it is saying that the way India is the largest country in the world, seventh largest country in the world, the way Asia, what it is telling us about Asia is that Asia is the largest continent in the world. Out of all the seven continents, Asia is the largest one. And what it comprises of. Out of suppose we have suppose for example this is earth, okay. Out of 75% we have water around, and approx 25% land we have. I'm just giving you the approx figure. So 75 and 25. So out of this 25%, we have this now. This 25% is our land, the earth, the area of the earth. Out of 25%, we have land. And out of this 25%, 30% is Asia only. We have a total of 25% land. अर्थ का जो पार्ट है उसमें से 25% लैंड है हमारे पास. आउट ऑफ अर्थ होल पार्ट वी हैव 25% लैंड ओनली. एंड ऑफ दैट 25% 30% पार्ट इज एशिया. एशिया कवर्स अ 30% पार्ट ऑफ द लैंड ऑफ अर्थ. दैट इज वाई इट इज द लार्जेस्ट कॉन्टिनेंट इन द वर्ल्ड. India is located in the southern part of the Asia. Like I shown you also in the last class where India is located. So it is located in the southern part of the Asia. Many countries have common boundaries with India. When you share your boundaries with the other countries, when one country shares its boundaries with the other countries, that countries are known as their neighboring countries. What they are known as? Neighboring countries. Like you share your particular locality, who are your neighbors, whom you call as your neighbors, who just live near your house, or sometime only when we call them neighbors, when their houses are just attached to their wall of their houses are attached to our walls. So in the same way, the neighboring countries are the countries which share the boundaries with the other countries. Like look here, this part you can see, this is the boundary of the India, okay. So the boundaries which India share with the other countries, which means कि इंडिया की बाउंड्री और किसी और कंट्री की अगर सेम बाउंड्रीज है, इफ द बाउंड्रीज ऑफ द टू कंट्रीज आर इंटरसेक्टिंग और इट्स सेम, सो दैट दोज कंट्रीज आर कॉल्ड एज नेबरिंग कंट्रीज. एंड इंडिया हैज 8 नेबरिंग कंट्रीज. दीज आर पाकिस्तान, अफगानिस्तान, नेपाल, भूटान, China, Myanmar and Bangladesh. Pakistan, Afghanistan, Nepal, Bhutan, China, Myanmar, Bangladesh. These are the 7 countries. Apart the one rest country is the Sri Lanka. Why we have written it separately? Because it is separating from the India by a narrow strait called the Pak Strait in the south. You can see here. See this part. This is Sri Lanka. This part which separates the Sri Lanka from India, this part is known as the Pak Strait. This part that is separating the Sri Lanka from the India's boundary is Pak Strait, and that is why it is also considered as the India's neighboring country. So we have 8 neighboring countries, that is Pakistan, Afghanistan, Nepal, Bhutan, China, Myanmar, Bangladesh and Sri Lanka. All these countries are the neighbors. लोकेट देम ऑन दी मैप ऑफ एशिया. वी कैन लोकेट दीज कंट्रीज इधर ऑन दी मैप ऑफ एशिया और वी कैन ऑल्सो लोकेट देम ऑन दी पॉलिटिकल मैप ऑफ इंडिया. ओके सो दिस पॉलिटिकल मैप शोज दी पॉलिटिकल डिविजन ऑफ इंडिया. लाइक वी हैव 28 स्टेट्स एंड 8 यूनियन टेरिटरीज एंड ऑल्सो वी हैव सम नेबरिंग कंट्रीज ऑल्सो. सो एंड इन द साउथ साइड वी हैव द वाटर बॉडीज. सो इफ आई टॉक अबाउट इंडिया वॉट आई विल से आई विल टेल अबाउट दैट इट इज़ द सेकेंड लार्जेस्ट कंट्री सेवेंथ लार्जेस्ट कंट्री इन द वर्ल्ड एंड सेकेंड लार्जेस्ट इन द टर्म्स ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट इट इज़ लोकेटेड ऑन द साउथर्न एशिया साउथर्न पार्ट ऑफ द एशिया. एंड इफ आई टॉक अबाउट द बाउंड्रीज ऑफ द कंट्री सो इट शेयर्स इट्स बाउंड्रीज फ्रॉम द नॉर्थ पार्ट ऑफ द इंडिया इज द लैंड बाउंड्री. इट कंप्राइजेज ऑफ द लैंड बाउंड्री मीन्स हाफ ऑफ द इंडिया हैज़ द वाटर बाउंड्रीज हाफ ऑफ द इंडिया हैज़ द लैंड बाउंड्रीज. मीन्स इफ आई कंसिडर द हाफ एरिया मीन्स नॉर्थ पार्ट ऑफ द इंडिया सो इट हैज़ द लैंड बाउंड्रीज एंड इन दीज लैंड बाउंड्रीज वी हैव द नेबरिंग कंट्रीज ऑफ द इंडिया. वेयर एज द हाफ पार्ट द अदर हाफ दैट मीन्स द साउथर्न पार्ट दिस साउथर्न पार्ट हैज़ द वाटर बाउंड्रीज. यू कैन सी दैट हेयर ऑल वाटर इज देयर. थ्री वाटर बॉडीज आर देयर इन द साउथर्न पार्ट ऑफ द इंडिया. सो विच मीन्स हाफ ऑफ द इंडिया कंप्राइजेज ऑफ द लैंड बाउंड्री एंड हाफ ऑफ द इंडिया कंप्राइजेज ऑफ द वाटर बाउंड्रीज. टू इट्स नॉर्थ इंडिया कंप्राइजेज लैंड बाउंड्री एंड टू इट्स साउथ एन ओशन बाउंड्री. ओशन बाउंड्री मीन्स वाटर ओनली. ओके सो दिस वॉज द पॉलिटिकल डिविजन ऑफ इंडिया दैट स्टेट्स एंड कैपिटल्स इज कॉल्ड एज द पॉलिटिकल डिविजन ऑफ इंडिया. नाउ मूविंग फॉरवर्ड फिजिकल डिविजन्स ऑफ इंडिया. द सर्फेस ऑफ अर्थ इज नॉट यूनिफॉर्म एट ऑल प्लेसेस इन इंडिया. इट ऑल्सो वेरीज फ्रॉम प्लेस टू प्लेस. वी हैव वेरी हाई माउंटेन्स वास्ट प्लेन्स ह्यूज डेजर्ट एंड अ ग्रेट प्लेट्यू रीजन. वॉट डज इट मीन्स यू कैन सी दैट दैट अर्थ इज नॉट हैव अ यूनिफॉर्म प्लेसेज एट ऑल. दैट मीन्स इट्स नॉट लाइक दैट द होल अर्थ हैज़ द माउंटेन्स ओनली और द होल अर्थ हैज़ द डेजर्ट्स ओनली और द होल अर्थ इज हैव द प्लेन्स ओनली. नो इट इज़ नॉट लाइक दैट. वी हैव सीन दैट इन सम एरियाज देयर इज नो गुड टेम्परेचर और आई वुड से नो गुड वेदर दैट इज दैट देयर इज अ डेजर्ट एरिया. डेजर्ट एरिया मीन्स वेरी हॉट क्लाइमेट इज देयर. ओके In some areas we have a mountains, in some areas we have the plains only, in some areas we have the coastal plains. Okay, so these are the different physical features the earth has. The same way the earth has so many different features, India also varies, has those features. From place to place these features of India varies from place to place. Like in some part of the India we have some other features, in some part of the India we have some other feature, and sometimes in the one part only that one part is also divided into further parts and we have the different features there. Like very high mountains, we have vast plains, deserts or a great plateau regions. So different kinds of physical features the earth has. The same way India also varies that features from place to place. We have 28 states. The same way we have the features also of different states. Different states has different features. Many rivers originate from the mountains and flow towards plains. At many places, these rivers make waterfalls. The climate of our country also varies from place to place. What it is saying that many rivers originate from mountains and flow towards the plains. At many places, these rivers make waterfalls. Now, what happens? There are so many rivers in India, and these rivers originate from where? These rivers originate from the mountains itself, and they flow towards, like, mountains have slopes, like this slope. So the rivers originate from here, and from here it flows towards the plains. Plains means plain areas. It moves towards plains, and in some of the places it come as a waterfalls also. Waterfall. Hope all of you have seen the waterfalls also. So these rivers that originate from the mountains and then flow towards the plain, they also sometimes make the waterfalls. Also, the climate of our country also varies from place to place. Why it varies? Why the climate also varies? Since if some area has the mountain there, so probably they have the cold temperature there. That means the climate there will be, climate kaisa hoga wahan ka, what kind of a climate does the mountain area have? Majorly the temperature there is cold, so winters are there majorly, and even in the summers also they don't feel that it is too hot or something. Okay, and the same way deserts, why that climate is different there? Due to the sand there, due to the temperature there. The temperature there is very high, that is very hot there. Same way we have the coastal plains or normal plain, in the plains only. So in that area we have a different kind of temperatures, and these temperatures only form the climate. So due to the physical features we has, due to the variety of the physical features, due to the variety of physical features, the climate also varies. The people of India belong to many religious tribes and races. And also people also belong to different religions, tribes and races. They also speak different languages, wear different kinds of dresses and eat different kinds of food. We have so many things different in India. Different states, different capitals, different union territories, different people, different languages, different clothes to wear, different languages to speak, different religions to follow, different things to eat, different dresses we wear. So everything is so different, but we all are united as one. Even having so much of differences, even having so much of differences in the weather, in the states, in everything we do, still we are united as one. We are proud to call ourselves Indian. We are very proud to call ourselves Indians. Our country is marked by a diversity of physical features such as mountains, plateaus, plains, coast, and islands. Now, you know that there are so much different people live in your country. They follow different religions, they wear different dresses according to their states they live in, the festivals they perform, different foods they eat, speciality of every state is different. So we have so much variety in everything. The same way we have the variety in the physical features also. Diversity means variety in the physical features also. Like mountains are there, plateaus are there, plains are there, coasts are there, and islands are there. So the physical division of India is, what is the physical division of India? How the India is divided physically? It is the Himalayan mountains in the north. It is divided into the six parts. What? Six parts. the Himalayan mountains in the north, the northern plains, the great Indian desert in the west. The peninsular plateau in the south and the coastal plains and the islands. So these are the six physical divisions of the India. Now I'll show you one by one. Why peninsular plateau in south? Because I told you that the area which is surrounded by the water bodies from the three sides is called as the peninsula. कोई भी जगह अगर three sides से three boundaries से किसी भी water bodies से covered होती है surrounded होती है then we call it as a peninsula. When any place is surrounded by a water body from the three boundaries or from the three sides, it is called as peninsula. That is why the southern part of India is called as the peninsular plateau. Plateaus are there, but why peninsular? Because the southern part, this it is a cone like southern part, this three sides are covered with water. Then the coastal plains and the islands. I'll show you the this part. You can see this brownish part. This is our mountains. It starts from stretch from Himalayas and towards here Arunachal Pradesh also. Then this green part represents, this dark green part represents the plains area. Here the key is given. Key is given means this colors describes us that what this part is, which color represents which part. Like I have colored this area a brown. I have colored this in brown. So what does this brown color represents? This brown color represents the mountains. Then green color represents the plains. And then if I move forward, here this yellow part is there. Yellow part is what? Yellow part is desert. Then here orangish part is there. This majorly part is orangish. This is our plateaus. And then this light green part is the coastal plains. So this was there in our chapter. We have done with the reading part, the explanation also. In the next session, I will just go through the chapter again. We'll discuss all the points again. And then we'll start with the book exercise. These are the quickies. Quickies means keywords. Everything will be posted there on the Snap homework. I hope you everyone check it daily. The Snap homework also and the YouTube also for your videos. So these are the keywords which you have to learn. Ocean, what are oceans, what are plateaus, what are waterfalls, what are subcontinent. So four keywords are there, you have to learn them. And after that, discussing the points again, we'll discuss the book exercise also. So that's all for today. We'll start it in the next session now. Thank you and take care.